like to call that Bloemfontein. First of all, I just want to call up leaders. Let me just say two overall leaders. It's Rochelle and Diesel, just to come and stand here. Just if you can face the congregation for a minute, just as everyone goes back to their seats. Thank you. So I want to just say right now, as I stand here, this is Rochelle. For those that don't know, this is my sister in Christ, Ellie. And this is my other sister in Christ, Diesel. And at least I'm able to see her eye to eye. I used to do this. I'm used to doing this with my prayer. I think maybe you could just share one of the two of you just a little bit about when the group started and just where the group is now.
Well, I had the opportunity to come share and be with you here in 2008 at the Soto Conference. And I think that's actually where this started, though I know that God planned it since before our births. We know that, right? And I think at that point there was some prophecy spoken over my life at that conference as well, that I never realized that God really wanted to use me in a leadership position. And that's the first time that it came over my life. My spirit was receptive for it. And that's when everything started. And Pastor Deb and I started having communication about something in Loom in 2009. And she kept telling me that something needs to be done in Loom. Something's going to happen. Something's going to be birthed in Loom.
Hallelujah.
But I told her I'm in Lady Brand. I wasn't in Loom at that stage. I was living in Lady Brand. It's a small town close to Loom. So I was in Lady Brand, and we spoke for a couple of years. And I just started in my heart and just fixing me. Because he needed to get me up to a certain place before I could be the leader or the person that he wanted me to be, before I could be example to other people. So he was working in my life, and I know he was also working in her life for a couple of years. And in 2011, last year, everything got together, and we kept praying, Pastor Deborah and myself, we kept praying for God's timing. But I know that God had to finish a work in my life first, and he finished work in her life as well. Us to that point where we would be ready. And then God brought the timing last year, and this group was birthed. And I think long before that, it was birthed in the spirit, but I think then it just physically manifested and it started. And at that stage, you took leadership. I was the lady grand, and God just moved all the obstacles out of the way. So the beginning this year, I would do that too, from there as well. And that's really where the whole thing. Since the beginning of this year, God is really moving and taking us places.
So I'm just talking about voice. There's no rain in the room, it's a crazy dust thing going on. That only sounds frightening. Yes, just a bit about what we do. Our vision that God gave us is. All accepted, all blessed. To be a blessing to others. So everybody's accepted in our group. Doesn't matter who you are or where you come from. Everybody's welcome. Everybody's a blessing, but we can't keep the blessings for ourselves. We have to put the blessings out there. And that's why we're very involved with one particular orphanage. We do lots of work with them. We help them. We provide them with things. We help them with church in Lesotho. As you guys know, Lesotho is people there who can't even afford shoes. So we've been providing them. We've helped a couple of people through high school. We're helping somebody with a computer course at the moment. We're helping the church in Lady Brand, also very poor Sotho people. We provide them with Bibles and things like that. And God's just moving. I mean, we opened a bank account 2 months ago. If I tell you how much is in that bank account, you probably won't believe me. But that's just the power of God. And He's using us. As I said, that blessing can't stay with us. And that blessing has to come to God. That's our main mission, is to bring the blessing of God out here. And our group is growing. Every second week we've got a new face. And yeah, we're about to celebrate our 1 year, so that's also going to be something really exciting. So I just want to thank God for all the support and guidance. And when I say we're moving into the supernatural, that's an understatement. Because we're moving into the supernatural. Yeah. name, we were working on this for a while, and God actually went beyond our name. I did a teaching a couple of months ago on the different names of God, and we were discussing what could our name be, and just out of my mouth came Adonai. Okay, and I don't know if you know, but Adonai is an old Hebrew word, and it talks about the full inclusivity of God. It's not just God the Father, but it's God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. It talks about God in everything, and I think that was really good representative of our name, to talk about God that represents everything and everybody.
Amen.
Okay, so the name of our fellowship is Adonai Fellowship.
Amen. Hallelujah. We just encouraged, we were very encouraged, first of all, just to see the amazing way this group just started to grow and flourish, and as the seed was birthed, you know, God is the one that waters it. God is the one that makes it grow. And, you know, the most important thing is that the two of you have stayed faithful as servants. And, you know, I just want to read that, because the reason that they're up here tonight and they're here with some of their leaders, and they've just really started getting structure into the group and put a name to their group, which is now a fellowship. It's moved from being a homestead group to becoming a fellowship. So it's really in the process of becoming a church. This is really what they are. They're a group of believers. They're a church. They're now officially a fellowship. And they are here tonight with us because we've just been spending some time. We've really just been having fellowship and prayer together, and just searching the heart of God. And we've been journeying for some time, and we've been asked some time back, I don't know if it was about 2 years ago or so, to when this thing was still in its stages of birthing, to look at spiritual oversight as a body, as the Gloria Family Church, to be spiritual oversight. And one thing we don't want is for routinization to happen, and that's not a big fancy word, it just simply means we don't want a whole lot of little dad Glorias all over the show. You know, because then everybody has to, then there's this blueprint and then that should be like that. No, you want the spirit of the mother group or church, whatever it is, to be captured in the hearts of the believers, of those that are affiliated. So that apostolic spirit moves and shifts and works individually in the heart of another church. And so they've got this name Adonai, because that's going to be their unique fingerprint for this group. And we, you know, we have spiritual oversight, and both of them as leaders are accountable to me and accountable to this church. And so they have the covering, they have our covering over them for that reason. So they're not just operating as renegade people just deciding, okay, this is what we're going to do. I really believe that they are both called of God. There's a special calling in 2008. That's what I saw on Liesl's life. I hadn't met Rochelle yet at that stage, but at our conference I saw that on my sister's life. And look, it's now how many years later? Three? Four. 4 years later, and the time has been right, and God is about to just flourish this group. We see such a beautiful spirit and anointing. And so tonight, really, what I'm here to do is to affirm the two of them as the pastoral leaders of Adonai Fellowship that sit under our spiritual oversight. Just to affirm them, because the Bible says we must lay hands on those, right? And so we want to lay hands on them to affirm them in the roles that they've been called to do publicly, so that all of you can see and know that they are called to be pastoral leaders of this group. And then what we're going to do is, at a time that God needs us, we're going to go there and do a special ceremony of ordination for them, official ordination in their home territory with all of their people in their church. And so let's just look at 1 Corinthians 4:2 quickly. I'm not going to go through the whole thing, because we're not doing a ceremony tonight. We're simply laying on hands to affirm them. And this is somewhat of a ceremony, if you like, because really the laying on of hands is a very serious business. The Bible says, do not be hasty to lay hands on people. And we are not hasty to lay hands on people. But we know that they are called, and we want to lay hands on them to affirm their calling in Christ as overall leaders of this church and in our fellowship. And in our fellowship, which is about to be released in the spiritual realm, yes, the new magnitude. Amen.
Yes.
So 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 2 says this: now it is required of those that have been given a trust that they must prove faithful.
Yes.
And the one thing I can say, Rochelle and Liesl, I've watched you from afar, I've watched you from in here, and I can say that the one thing that has amazed me, that I love about you, is that you've remained faithful. You might say it's just a year, but it is not easy because there's been a consistency. The Bible says there must be that consistency that runs through us all, that brings us into that maturity. And you've had a lot of blocks thrown at you along the way from the devil's side of it, and you've stayed faithful. And so you've proved faithful, and I want to affirm your calling in the Lord. And as overall leaders of this fellowship tonight, and as God leads you, I want to affirm that calling and lay hands on you as the spiritual oversight that you've asked us to be as we've journeyed with you. We know this is going to go from strength to strength. Amen. And I'd like to ask the other leaders, if you could come around, please just surround. And also, can I ask my leaders, just somebody representing maybe Pastor Brand. And we can get some quick sentiment later. If you could just stand around them over there on the side, some on this side, y'all, just a semicircle, that's good. That's good. Amen. This is a very special time. This is a very special time. Let's just bring you a fruit forward. This is a time that you know has been coming for many, many years, my sister. And you are about to be anointed. You see, David was anointed in private, and he was told by the Holy Spirit through the prophet that he would be king. But he was first anointed in private before it was made public. So God has spoken to them about their calling already, but now it's being affirmed publicly, just as Scripture asks us to do. And so we're doing that right now in the name of Jesus. My sisters, lift up your hand. These are right now, I declare in the name of Jesus Christ, that I affirm your calling as a pastoral leader of Adonai Fellowship and all that God has called you to do and be. And I lay hands on you right now and anoint your head with oil. And I put that seal of your calling upon your life right now and affirm it over you. And I also release right now an apostolic mantle over your life and over this ministry right now. And I speak the fire of God right now. I release over you an anointing of the apostolic.
Right now, the blood of your life.
where he said, choose whom you will serve this day. And you say, Lord, I choose you. As for me and my house, Lord, we will serve the Lord. Yesterday, my shepherd, and I release over you their servants. Sent you apart by the laying on of hands according to scripture.